As I work on this video, these are the COVID-19 statistics as reported by the World Health Organization. Time and time again through history, science and technology have played a very important role in the progress and evolution process of our world and life as we know it. Today, we look at some ways by which emerging technologies are helping in the fight of the COVID-19 pandemic. These are technologies whose developments, practical applications, or both are still largely unrealized, like AI or 3D printing. Biochemists in the UK have developed a Snoot with gem trap technology. Its creators say the fabric coating has a similar formation to the carbohydrate structures on the surface of cells that cover the esophagus. They created the technology by attaching glycoproteins to carbon cloth and then to other cheaper materials such as cotton. Their tests have shown that it traps 96% of airborne viruses. According to the inventor, Paul Hope, the Snoot is more breathable and flexible than a conventional mask, meaning patients can also wear them. The Shenzhen-based company, known as KC Wearable, has developed a smart helmet that can detect people with fever up to 5 meters away, sounding an alarm when anyone with high temperature comes close. The headset, which is already in use by police in Shenzhen, Chengdu, and Shanghai, features an infrared temperature detector, an augmented reality visor, a camera that can read QR codes, plus Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, and 5G so it can beam data to the nearest hospital. Equipped with facial recognition technology, the helmet can also display the subject's name on the AR visor as well as their medical history. An Italian company came to the rescue after a hospital ran out of crucial valves for its ventilators in northern Italy. Isinova reverse engineered the existing valve and had a prototype ready within 6 hours, with 100 working valves printed and supplied to the hospital within a day. Chinese company Winsun has deployed its rapid 3D printing powers on an architectural scale, manufacturing 15 coronavirus isolation wards within a single day. Czech company Prusa has started mass production of protective face shields used by medics. It is manufacturing over 800 pieces a day and has donated 10,000 pieces to the Czech Ministry of Health. Drones originally designed to spray pesticides for agricultural applications were adapted in China to spray disinfecting chemicals in some public spaces and on epidemic prevention vehicles traveling between impacted areas. This spraying helps reduce the transmission mechanisms of the coronavirus. Drones are also being used for delivery of supplies and food. The Corona 100 Meters app uses a wealth of data collected by the government's testing program. The app alerts users when they come within 100 meters of a location visited by an infected person. It is the most popular app in South Korea with 1 million downloads in 17 days. Let's not forget the cloud-based applications many of us are using as we collaborate and work remotely from home and also keep in touch with our families and loved ones. Just as seen on your screen, an engineering student is modifying a robot to observe and screen COVID-19 patients. Other robots are being deployed to minimize human-to-human contacts by delivering food, medicines, or talking to patients. Here are some regular technologies that many of us have probably employed to keep us entertained while we stay home with our family, friends, and loved ones throughout this quarantine period. On behalf of all living things on planet Earth, we at Delali would like to say a big thank you to all health workers and anyone out there risking it all to make sure people get well soon and get back to their families in peace. Thank you, yes you, for staying home to ensure life can return to normal as soon as possible. Kindly give us a thumbs up, subscribe and ring the notification bell to stay in touch. Stay home and stay safe. See you next time.